चलेगा तुम विनती करी तेरी पाव पड़े तोरे कितना मनाया फिर भी नहीं सुनी रे छोड़ के कहाँ चले गिरत रात अंधेरा डरावे लोहित मोहे रुलावे पंछी अकेला सुना है बसेरा वाट तकत तुरे आवन की छोड़ के कहाँ चले
प्रकाशी समन्वयार्थ महाबाहु ब्रह्मपुत्र महामिलनार तीर्थ कत युग धरी आई से प्रकाशी समन्वयार्थ महाबाहु ब्रह्मपुत्र কুবুজরে পরা বার ভূঁয়া আহিছিলে কেই বংশতে শঙ্কৰ দেউ ইয়াতে জন্মিলে মৰুৰ দেশৰে আজান ফকীৰে মধুৰ জিকিৰ ৰচিলে দিল্লীৰ দিলোৱাৰে আহি হস্তি পুঠি আঁকিলে পঞ্চ নদীৰ তেগ বাহাদুৰে ধৰ্মৰ সেতু গঢ়িলে সমন্বয়ৰ দেখুৱালে কত প্ৰকাশ স্ফূৰ্ত মহাবাহু ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ লাচিতে শৰাই ঘাটতে কতৰু আগচিলে জাতি ধৰ্ম ভাষা সবাকে স্বদেশ প্ৰেমেৰে বান্ধিলে কিৰাট পুত্ৰ বিষ্ণু ৰাভাই মাটিৰ দৃষ্টি জিয়ালে সমন্বয়ৰ দেখুৱালে কত প্ৰকাশ স্ফূৰ্ত মহাবাহু ব্ৰহ্মপুত্ৰ পদ্মা নদী কত শত জনাহিলে লুইতৰ দুয়ো পাৰে কতনা অতিথি আদৰিলে কিছু ল'ব লাগে কিছু দিব লাগে জিন যাবলৈ হ'লে মিলিব লাগে মিলাব লাগে ৰবীন্দ্ৰনাথেও ক'লে অগ্রওয়াল জ্যোতি ইয়াতে জ্যোতির প্রপাত বোয়ালে অজিন পাতকি খবর চক্র জ্যোতিরে করি ব্যর্থ মহাবাহু ব্রহ্মপুত্র মহামিলনর তীর্থ কত যুগ ধরি আহিসে প্রকাশি সমন্বয়র অর্থ মহাবাহু ব্রহ্মপুত্র
নমস্কার, আই এম ভূপেন হাজারিকা। আই এম গোয়িং টু টেক ইউ অন এ জার্নি অ্যালং দ্য রিভার ব্রহ্মপুত্র। ইউ উইল এনজয় দ্য প্লেজার অফ দ্য মিরিয়াড মিথস, মেথোলজি, হিস্টোরি অ্যান্ড কালচার অফ দিস ওয়ান্ডারফুল সিভিলাইজেশনস দ্যাট হ্যাভ স্প্রাং অন দ্য ব্যাঙ্কস অফ দিস গ্রেট রিভার। দ্য ব্রহ্মপুত্র অ্যান্ড ইটস নিউমারাস ট্রিবিউটারিজ কাট অ্যাক্রস 8 states of our mighty country and are called Northeastern India. And this great river is the only male river in India. Brahmaputra, the name has been derived because Brahma means the creator and Putra means son. And together it means son of Brahma or Brahmaputra. This river which has given life to my civilization, from where I have sprung from in Assamese, is called Luhit, and in Sanskrit it is called Lohit. Both mean the red river. Through the mists and cobwebs of time, a story has emerged, told to me by my grandmother, which I want to share with you. It is said that Parshuram, the mythological figure from the Hindu religion, is said to have murdered his mother. In remorse, he went up to the mouth of the river Brahmaputra, to its very beginning when it enters Assam. Parshuram dipped the axe in the river waters, not only to wash off the blood-stained axe, but to wash off his sins for committing this terrible act of matricide. Henceforth, this point has been named Parashuram Kund, and the river tainted with blood earned its name the Red River. Thus, this son of Brahma, the Red River Luhit, has given birth to mighty civilizations, which, steeped in centuries of mysticism and spirituality, have embraced all religion with equality on both sides of its broad banks. The Brahmaputra continues to emanate a harmonious atmosphere of religious tolerance, peace, integration, and compassion for humanity. The raging male river, which is deceptively calm, can be very cruel when in spate. The river then rapes, crushes, and swallows this fertile land, changing its course recklessly, annihilating life in every form, be it man, plant, or animal.
Arunachal Pradesh means land of the dawnlit mountains or land of the rising sun. Pradesh means state or region. The McMahon line separates it from the zone of control of the People's Republic of China to the north, and it has Itanagar as the capital of the state. Arunachal Pradesh was administered as the Northeast Frontier Agency or NEFA until 1972, when it became the Union Territory of Arunachal Pradesh. It was given full statehood in November 1986. Except for the northwestern part of the state, little is known about the history of Arunachal Pradesh. Northwestern part of this area came under the control of Mongpa Kingdom of Monyu, which flourished between 500 BC and 600 AD. This region then came under the loose control of Tibet and Bhutan, especially in the northern areas. The remaining parts of the state, those bordering Myanmar, came under the control of the Ahom and the Assamese until the annexation of India by the British in 1858. Brahmaputra. The mighty river Brahmaputra, as it's known, flows through the entire stretch of Assam. The mythology of Assam is reconstructed from epics and literature from early times. In historical times, it came to be named as the Kamrup Kingdom. The kingdom roughly falls in modern-day Assam in India. The kingdom was ruled by the Varman dynasty, the Millet Chard dynasty, and the Pala dynasty up to the 12th century. After which, the Khen dynasty moved the capital to the west and began calling the kingdom the Kamata Kingdom. The Kamarupa Kingdom thus ended in the 12th century with the fall of the Pala rulers. In the 16th century, Vishwasingha of the Koch tribe established the Koch dynasty in the Kamata Kingdom. In the eastern part of the old Kamarup Kingdom, the Kachari and the Sutya Kingdom arose, with portions controlled by the Bhuya chieftain. In the tract between the Kachas and the Sutya kingdoms, a Shan group established the Ahom Kingdom. The history of the Ahom Kingdom begins in the early 13th century. Sukhapa, a Shan, Mong Mao prince, crossed the Patkai Hills, fought and defeated the Nagas, and reached the Brahmaputra Valley in 1228. And Sukhapa finally established his kingdom at Soraidyo, near present-day Shivsagar, in 1253. The Ahom Kingdom then consolidated its powers for the next 300 years or so. When the Treaty of Yandabu in 1826 paved the way for the British to convert the Ahom Kingdom into a principality, which marked the end of the golden Ahom rule. In 1839, the annexation of Assam was complete by the British, which annexed the whole of Assam into British India. Nagaland is the furthest line state in northeast India. The state capital is Kohima and the largest city is Dimapur. The Naga tribes have socio-economic and political links with tribes in Assam and Myanmar, and even today, a large population of Nagas inhabit Assam. When the British East India Company took control of Assam in 1826, they steadily expanded their domain over modern Nagaland. Many Naga tribes embraced Christianity, in particular, the Baptist faith. After the independence of India in 1947, the area remained a part of the province of Assam. In July 1960, a political accord was reached at Naga People's Convention that Nagaland should become a constituent and self-governing state in the Indian Union, and statehood was officially granted in 1963. Meghalaya is a small state in northeastern India. The word Meghalaya literally means the abode of the clouds. About one-third of the state is forested. The Khasi, Garo, and Jaintia tribes each had their own kingdom until they came under the British administration in the 19th century. Later, the British incorporated Meghalaya into Assam in 1835. The region enjoyed semi-independent status by virtue of a treaty relationship with the British Crown. In 1947, the present-day Meghalaya constituted two districts of Assam and enjoyed limited autonomy within the state of Assam. In 1971, the Parliament passed the Northeastern Areas Reorganization Act 1971, which conferred full statehood on the autonomous state of Meghalaya, and Meghalaya attained statehood on 21st Jan 1972 with the legislative assembly of its own. Manipur is a state in Northeast India, making its capital the city of Imphal. The Methis, who live primarily in the state's valley region, is one of the primary ethnic groups. The British, ruling neighboring Bengal, to safeguard their position against the Burmese invasion, intervened, defeated Burma, and took over Assam, and brought Manipur under British paramountcy in 1891. During the Second World War, Manipur was the scene of many fierce battles between the Japanese and the Allied forces. The Japanese came up to Manipur. They and fractions of the Indian National Army, under the command of Subhash Chandra Bose, were beaten back before they could enter Imphal, and this proved to be one of the turning points of the war. In 1947, with British Parliament repeal of the British paramountcy, in preparation for India's independence, Manipur became an independent kingdom once again. The king, Maharaja Buddhachandra, began a process of democratization of the state, enacting the Manipur Constitutional Act 1947, which established a democratic form of government. In 1949, the King Buddhachandra was invited to Shillong, capital of the Indian province of Assam, where he signed an agreement for annexation of the kingdom into India. Later on, it was further made into the status of a union territory from 1956 onwards. In 1972, Manipur was elevated to the status of a state. Mizoram is a mountainous region which became the 23rd state of the Indian Union in February 1987. The origin of the Mizos, like those of many other tribes in the northeastern India, is shrouded in mystery. It is generally accepted that they were a part of a great Mongoloid wave of migration from China. The earliest Mizos who migrated to India were known as Kukis. The Lusai were the last of the Mizo tribes to migrate to India. The Mizo Hills were formally declared as part of British India by a proclamation in 1895. The Mizo National Front was outlawed in 1967. The demand for statehood gained fresh momentum. The Union Territory of Mizoram came into being on 21st Jan 1972. Statehood was a prerequisite to the implementing of the accord signed between the Mizo National Front and the Union Government of India on 30th June 1986. The formalization of the Mizoram state took place on 20th February 1987. Tripura, meaning three cities in Sanskrit, was apparently constructed by the great architect Mayasur. They were great cities of prosperity, power, and dominance over the world. But due to the imprecise nature, Maya cities were destroyed by Lord Shiva. We then arrived into the ancient period of Tripura, which can be said existed from around the 7th century when the Tripuri king ruled from Kailash Sheher in North Tripura. Then we arrived to the historical period in Tripura. The kings of Tripura adopted the Manikya title and shifted their capital to Udaipur in the 14th century. This was their most glorious period, and their power and fame was acknowledged by the Mughals. And the modern period in Tripura starts after the domination of the kingdom by the Mughals and thereafter by the British, who defeated the Mughals. During this period, the capital of the Kingdom of Tripura was shifted to Agartala in West Tripura. In the early part of the 19th century AD, the present state capital is in Agartala still. By January 1948, the central government of India assumed charge and the state continued to be ruled directly for many years, Tripura has now been recognized as a state of the Indian Union in its own right, and the democratic government has been in place for 30 years. Sikkim is a landlocked Indian state nestled in the Himalayas. Sikkim was an independent state ruled by the Chogyal monarchy until 1975, when a referendum was held and the population voted to join India as its 22nd state. The predominant religions are Hinduism and Vajrayana Buddhism. Gangtok is the capital and largest town. The Kanchenjunga, the world's third highest peak, is located in Sikkim. Not much is known about Sikkim's ancient history, except for the fact that the first inhabitants were the Lepchas. They were later encompassed and absorbed by the earliest known fact about Sikkim, which was that the Buddhist saint Guru Rinpoche passed through the land in the 9th century. The Guru introduced Buddhism to Sikkim and also foretold the era of the monarchy in the state, which would arrive centuries later in the 13th century.
As I bid you goodbye, I want to underline that this great northeastern civilization spread over 8 states is still today resilient, courageous and unvanquishable. The northeastern part of India will not succumb to any pressure of corrosion of the river waters, nor to any statements of secessionism. The entire Northeast has been and is and continues to be an integral and a very vital part of our great country, India.
चले कहाँ तुम विनती करी तेरी पाप पड़े तोरे कितना मनाया फिर भी नहीं सुनी रे छोड़ के कहाँ चले